challenge program. All right, so this week we have an all new 5x5 routine. This is for those of you participating at home, those of you participating live. Try to get this workout in at least 2 times this week. All right, here's what we got. We're gonna do a push-up and then a stand-up press-up. So you're gonna be using your weights, okay? You can do your push-ups to a stair, which is a little bit easier. You can do it to the ground or to a bench, and I'm gonna use the bench. We're gonna do one push-up, one stand-up and press. Are you ready? Here we go. So you wanna keep your back flat, lower your chest down, push up, step in, grab your weights, press up. That's one. Step back, push up, step in. Two. We're doing 5 of these bad boys. Step out. Push up, step in, grab your weights. Three. Now, if you're feeling like you really want to advance it, let's take it to the ground, okay? Right here we go. You can do a push up holding the weight. Push up, step in, pick up, press it, that's 4. So you have many options, okay? Push up, step in, and 5. Sweet, good job. Now, we're gonna touch our butt and do curls. So, from a seated position, I'm sure you have chairs in your house. You can use any dining room chair, even a step, or a bar stool. So you're gonna, I'm a little bottom heavy here. Stand up and curl. Touch your butt. Stand up and curl. It's 2. Touch your butt. 3. Come on up, curl. 4. And 5. Awesome. Next exercise, just using one dumbbell. Okay? You're gonna chop to one side. Just do a chop like that. You can just do 5 of those, but I'd like to do a chop with a pull. High knee pull. So it's chop, high knee pull, chop. We're going to do 5 each side. If you can't, you don't have the ability to balance on one leg, just do 5 chops on one side. Take your time with it. Chop, 5 on one, 5 on the other. So here we go. Chop, pull. 1. Chop, 2, chop, all the way up, nice and tall with those weight, with the weight, 3, chop, 4, chop, 5, all right, other side, arms are up straight, chop to the side, it's called a wood chop, 1, chop, 2, chop, 3, you feel that hurry getting up. 4, and 5, awesome. Now, dumbbell front raise with a tricep extension. So, looks like this, you're gonna front raise all the way up, tricep down your back, let it stretch out the tricep, press it up, and then again, slower it in front of you. So we're working shoulders and triceps. 1, press it high. Front raise up, 2, press it high. Front raise up, 3, press it up, 4, working those shoulders and triceps, 5, nice. All right, now you'll need a mat today. We are gonna do some sit-ups and some hamstring exercises. Okay, I think you can see me just fine here. We are gonna do a dumbbell sit-up, okay? Move my bench back now. You just need one dumbbell. You're gonna take it over your head, like so, and touch it to your bench or touch it to your toes, whatever you can do. We're gonna do 5 of these. 2, 3, reach it far over your head. 4, reach, reach, reach. And 5. Now, set that down. You can use any chair. You don't have to have a bench. You can even use the steps. You want to bring your butt in close. Put your feet on top. We're going to work the hamstrings. Just like this. And you're just going to do a hip press. 1. Press it high. 2. If you want more resistance, you can put the weight on your hips. Just like this. me to get through all five. Don't stop at just going through it one time. Get through it at least 2 to 3 times, okay? We only did 5 reps. It's doing something, you're getting your heart rate up, but if you really want an effective workout, ideally, I'd like you to get through it 5 times, but at least 3 to 5 times, so you're getting 15 to 25 reps of each exercise, okay? Don't just stop after one time through. And you can break it up throughout the day. Do it once when you first get up, middle of the day, lunchtime, middle of the day again, dinner time before you go to bed, or do it all at once. Just keep moving. You want to get that heart rate up, get a good burn. That's this week's